Things you can do right now to tip the scales in your favor prior to them coming in. Number one, there you go. 10 things that you can do right now to and we close with this. 10 things you can do right now to tip the scales in your favor prior to them coming in. Number one, phone the lead as soon as possible. Oh, Ryan, we've heard you say that. Really? Do you really understand? You're done. Many of you are going to grow your practice just with this lead. He has the stats. If you phone someone in 5 minutes, you have 100 times, not 100%, 100 times more likelihood of getting them. The odds that that lead is contacted is 100 times greater than if contacted 30 minutes after submission. How many of you get depressed by that? That is a depressing stat. You miss the 5 minute window, 100 times more harder to get them in if you phone 30 minutes as opposed to 5 minutes. He has actual stats on conversions into money. If you phone within 1 minute, there's a 391% improvement on conversions. 2 minutes, 160, 98%, etc. My belief on the stat is that that's actually on monetary value as opposed to just getting them in. The first one was getting them in. This one is just the whole sales process and getting them in sooner. Remember, time between kills. Time between kills, time with increases. Time between kills, time with increases. So number two, pay before they arrive. These are things that I wouldn't have put this on the slide 6 months ago. But now I'm absolutely convinced that if someone is not prepared to pay, the biggest challenge with one-on-one sales is spending time with unqualified leads. That's part of the process, by the way, but we have to do things in our power to increase that. If you're getting tons of leads and you're getting them to pay in advance and certain people won't pay in advance, then you don't see them if you're getting tons of leads. It's different if you don't have enough new patients. If you're generating 10 plus new patients a week, you need to start increasing your initial consultation fee, and you need to start absolutely insisting that people pay in advance. I'm absolutely 100% convinced that if a prospect sits in front of you and they've paid prior to coming to see you, the chances of conversion is exponentially increased. Absolutely convinced of that. And if they won't pay, they're probably never going to pay. So I'm going to caveat there. If you have low deal flow, you don't have that luxury. People are like, oh, that's fine. They're not going to see them. I'm only getting 3 new patients a week. Well, you need a certain level of deal flow to actually grow, just so we're clear. Welcome packs or anything in the post. Send anything in the post. Book, welcome letter, newsletter, social proof, tear sheet. I don't know if you guys know what a tear sheet is. Yeah, a tear sheet is something that's made famous with direct copywriting, direct response marketers. And it's essentially a fake newspaper article that presents you as the expert. Now, I say tear sheet not for that purpose, but most of you have had either a newspaper article or something like that. Most of you have had this before. So a tear sheet might be an actual newspaper article where you were positioned as the expert. You want to put that in front of the prospect. I'm just telling you what it is for you, for your history. Traditional media proof, you know, if you send anything or you show them anything in emails or posts or anything where you were on a TV show. Listen, if you were on freaking the Dr. Oz show, you want everyone to see that prior to coming to see you. It changes the selling environment. Number four, published author. It is literally now a prerequisite if you're in the expert business, and you're all in the expert business. You're all in the expert business, by the way. Everybody wants to see an expert. Everybody wants to see the best, right? Like, whenever I go to America, I laugh. It's like so different there as opposed to different European countries, etc. But there's whole marketing projects where you can pay to be positioned as the top doc in the area, like voted prize, like the best plastic surgeon in Phoenix. Right? Just pay for that to be positioned on a magazine. Your opinions, whether that's ethical or not, are irrelevant. The process I'm talking about right now is that definitely affects, I'm not recommending that, by the way, but that absolutely affects the sale. So all those people are doing is they're sending that magazine across to every person that comes to see them to show them on the front cover of Consultants Monthly. Come see the voted the top consultant in Phoenix. Like, freaking out, I don't want to see that guy. In fact, I Google that, right? Even me. So you understand that that absolutely affects the sale. So part of my inner circle group, we do a done with your book. If you haven't done it, get on it. Number five, overboard reminders or frequency prior to them coming in. Number six, indoctrination sequence or some type of sequence. Everyone gets this wrong. If you some type of email sequence prior to them coming in, the only purpose of it is not to educate. The only purpose is to bond with you. And my associates in the call, you're slightly disadvantaged here. Because in any multi-purpose practice or multi-doc practice, it's harder to position one person as the out-and-out expert. In Belinda, your practice, or Simon, your practice, or one of it's like easy. You, the guy, you, the girl, it's easy to position. You are the expert, and all the copy, all the photos, everything's positioned around you being the expert. Number seven, demonstration prior to the initial consultation. What I mean by that is demonstration in the waiting room. Is there posters of you as celebrities? Is there testimonials? Is there testimonials in the newsletter, in the emails, in the everything? Anything you can do to say demonstration. How long have people been coming for? A board that shows families, a board that shows, yes, a lot of practices do this, like the over hundreds club. How, if all the people have been adjusted over 100 times or been the 5 year and bus and above club, that changes the prospect's mind as to, people come here, you are trustworthy, people stay here. That changes everything and it really changes even the pre-framing of the sale. Number eight, future visit stats increased. I've spoken about this. Trust me, I guarantee your conversions increase if you increase your future visit stats from tomorrow. Everybody gets booked out to at least wherever you think is possible for you right now. I highly recommend first progress exam, which is at least 12 visits. I'm going to go in depth with this over the next few sessions, so please don't worry. I'm not skimming. I'm skimming over this, but I am going to go in depth all of this. Number nine, once you've increased deal flow, you may want to consider, I've already said this, increasing new patient fee. So I'm looking at clients right now who've got so good at marketing. They came to me, they weren't good. They've learned how to get lots of deal flow. Now it's time to increase your new patient fee. Simon, me, you had a conversation about this, et cetera. Now, Belinda, et cetera, people like that on the call. We want to now increase that so that we can have higher quality of lead. But be careful. My warning for you here right now is if you're under 10, you're not there yet, right? Get deal flow. Get deal flow. I'd say take it with a pinch of salt, probably anywhere close to five. Next pre-care camp class, but be careful. It was like, oh, care plan class. Pre-care class. So like before the initial consultation, lots of coaches teach this. The only time I take the lead, if someone goes to a class prior to initial examination, remember time with increases or decreases the sale, increases. So if they spend time with you in a care class prior to initial consultation, is the conversions going to be better? Absolutely. However, be careful. It's also going to chase some people away, which means if you don't have lots of deal flow, i.e., be able to market, you're not ready for that yet. I'm not a huge fan of it. I prefer getting face to face straight away. And I used to do only group reports, by the way, when I was seeing volume. It comes to a point in your career, by the way, if you really want to get to high volume, where you don't have a choice. You have to do this in some way, shape, or form, either before, between initial consultation report of findings, or after report. You have to. There's no choice because there's not. You can't. Your selling time is limited by one on one, and you have to go one to many. You don't have a choice. But you better be good at generating leads. Because if you're doing a pre-care class and you only got three new patients a week, it's going to be a pretty awkward class. And you're not going to leverage social proof. You want 30 people in that class. All of a sudden, sales go up. Number 11, omnipresence, which means now, after coaching with me for 2 years, I'm hearing this. People saying the following. People saying the following. I'm getting so many new patients saying, I've been watching your videos for so long. I've been seeing you online for so long, etc. All of a sudden, the selling environment changes with that.